Drones are rapidly being employed in a variety of industries nowadays, and that is a good thing. But on the other hand, they can be dangerous if not utilized properly, and drone misuse has become a major concern across the globe for a variety of reasons, from supplying contraband to prisons to delaying plane takeoffs to spying on individuals. So here we have the 10 best anti-drone systems for shooting drones out of the sky. But let me tell you something. If you like and subscribe right now, you're going to become a new drone hunter today. Birds of prey. Birds of prey are a potential alternative for law enforcement wanting to get rid of renegade drones. Eagles themselves are some of the animal kingdom's most effective hunters, with their massive wingspan and large talons. The method clearly works, but is it good for the bird? One concern is whether the raptor's feet would hold up against the rotors of larger, sturdier drones, but keep in mind that bald eagles have very high visual acuity. They can see exactly where the rotors are better than we could, and even if they did make contact with a rotor, it would be unlikely to do any real damage, at least for most commercially available drones, which tend to be relatively lightweight. The project is still in its testing phase. The police still have a few more months to determine whether the eagles represent a viable, sustainable anti-drone system. Humans have long partnered with animals to achieve our goals. Pigeons once served as spies during World War II, after all. Why not employ a troop of eagles to intercept hostile drones? Radar technology. Radar detection can also be used to detect unmanned aerial vehicles, or UAVs, for short. Traditional military and aviation radar systems, which are designed to pick up large aircraft, may struggle to pick up smaller drones or to distinguish them from other objects such as birds. They may also find it difficult to deal with drones that move slowly or hover. Modern anti-drone radar systems may use a variety of radar technologies, depending on requirements for range, size of the protection zone, number of simultaneous targets to track, and ability to deal with environmental clutter. They provide 3D airspace tracking and use sophisticated signal processing techniques to accurately detect and identify drones. As each detection method has its advantages and drawbacks, multi-sensor anti-drone systems will combine different sensor types along with sensor fusion algorithms to provide a complete integrated solution. DroneCatcher. What better way to catch a drone than with a drone? Created by Dutch firm Delft Dynamics, the DroneCatcher is a multicopter that surrounds target drones and either tows them to safety or drops them with a net. Some of the other anti-drone systems on this list can be damaging to a drone, but the DroneCatcher makes sure you can take out another drone without losing any incriminating evidence. After detection by, for example, a radar, vision, or an acoustic system, DroneCatcher is able to quickly approach hovering or moving threats. With the use of multiple onboard sensors, the net gun can be locked on the target, and due to its tracking capabilities, the drone will be swiftly caught by shooting a net. After the catch, DroneCatcher can carry the captured drone on a cable to a harmless place and release it there. If the caught drone is too heavy to be carried, it can be dropped with a parachute to ensure a low impact on the ground. Drone hacking. Hacking a drone in flight seems like something out of a spy movie, but it is quite possible. Drones can be hacked from as much as 1.6 kilometers away, and there are several different ways a drone can be hacked. A radio signal is often unencrypted, making it easy to decode with a packet analyzer or sniffer, so hacking a drone signal isn't technically demanding. Once the drone has been located, a hacker can potentially take control of it, or downlink video or other images which the drone is broadcasting to its base station. GPS spoofing, for example, feeds the drone false GPS coordinates. The drone thinks it is following its original flight pattern but in fact, is being led to a different location. Hijacking the command and control signals between the operator and the drone can deliver full control of the drone and its systems to the hacker. Just for fun, he might simply want to crash it deliberately or leave it with no way to navigate. DARPA Laser. The United States government is spending millions of dollars on anti-drone technology, for a good reason too. Though there have been no documented cases of people equipping drones with explosives for malicious purposes, there have been cases in Germany and Japan of people using drones as weapons. The Pentagon's Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA for short, is developing a new laser weapon that can shoot down and neutralize drones, and they are testing a number of devices which would be able to neutralize all types no matter the shape or size. The general idea is to use lasers to shoot down drones deemed a threat, which will also be deployed as a shield, protecting troops and allies from airborne threats. In layman's speak, DARPA wants an omnipresent death laser that can shield the country from a Star Wars-style post-apocalyptic drone invasion. SkyFence. As previously indicated, drones are becoming a popular means of smuggling contraband into jails. SkyFence is here to put a stop to it. It can be installed along an existing perimeter fence and create an electronic wall which extends into the sky. An operator-controlled drone is unable to fly through this wall. It is an electronic countermeasure system which prevents drones from flying into or close to a protected location by disrupting their command and navigation radio transmissions, in any weather, day or night. The SkyFence system uses a host of signal disruptors to jam the flight control signals of drones as they fly by, forcing them to fly back to where they originally took off. This type of system is scalable, meaning that it can be deployed along almost any fence line. It eliminates any impact on other electronic devices and only affects the drone in the sky, meaning it is safe to use at airports, prisons, and all other locations. DroneGun Tactical. The DroneGun Tactical was made to help keep the increasing number of flying robots in check. It is a highly effective UAS countermeasure designed for two-handed operation and long-range defeat. The product includes high-performance directional antennas in a lightweight, robust rifle-style design, featuring an intuitive control panel user interface to select and engage the range of jamming frequencies for target defeat. The DroneGun Tactical provides a safe countermeasure against a wide range of UAS threats, with no damage to common models or the surrounding environment. When disruption is triggered, targets will respond by either vertical on the spot landing or returning to their remote controller or starting point. It's currently only available to government agencies, but that could change soon. Death Ray Truck. There is always a fear that drones could potentially get into the wrong hands and be used as a terrorist weapons. Military contractors in the United States are more than prepared for that scenario. Go ahead and scoff at the sheer bulk of this 10-kilowatt capable anti-drone laser technology developed by Boeing. But just in case you didn't know, it is highly advanced and could function in heavy fog, rain, and wind. The Army's newest toy is the high-energy laser mobile demonstrator, known as the HELMD, which shoots a quarter-sized laser beam at its targets. Controlled with an Xbox-like controller, the HELMD aims its invisible beam at its target, heating up the spot until the enemy is neutralized. The laser can target the wings or tail of a drone or even its navigation sensors. The goal is to eventually increase the laser's strength to 100 kilowatts. If a 10-kilowatt laser is exceeding expectations right now, just imagine what a laser 10 times as strong could do. DroneDefender. This anti-drone weapon is a lightweight point-and-shoot device that looks like something out of modern warfare. The DroneDefender, which weighs 4 kilograms, operates instantly when the trigger is engaged, breaking the communication link from the pilot to the UAS. As a consequence, the UAS enters its pre-programmed safety mode, minimizing the risk to public safety and damage to the drone. A GPS disruption on a separate trigger can be used if the UAS continues moving or if it enters return to home mode and capture as desired. SkyWall 100. If you want something that resembles a loadout weapon from the video game Halo, this anti-drone catcher is definitely for you. Developed for law enforcement and security teams, the SkyWall 100 is a handheld system for the safe capture of drones. It weighs in at approximately 10 kilos and is a net-launching bazooka. Its smart scope system requires minimal training and uses predictive algorithms to ensure you hit your target. With its onboard AI computer, the bazooka analyzes the movements of the drone to ensure capture. Once the target is reached, the projectile deploys a specially designed net to entangle the drone, then uses a parachute to bring the whole package safely to the ground. This minimizes the risk of any collateral damage and keeps the drone intact. It allows forensic investigation and enables the identification of the operator. Don't worry if you need to defeat and eliminate several drones. The SkyWall can be recharged swiftly and efficiently. Drones worry a lot of people and can cause a lot of trouble when they are misused. I hope these systems do not start shooting down Amazon drones, but who knows what the future holds anymore. Leave a comment. Stay tuned and I'll see you next time.